First thing I want to say is, man, R.I.P. Prodigy from Mobb Deep. I'm like the only nigga in here, but I'm from the streets, man. When I listen to Prodigy, when I listen to Mobb Deep, it makes me just want to drink Henny and ride around with no seatbelt on. Alright. Oh, how y'all doing? Y'all good? Y'all chilling? My name is Cliff, you know, born and raised in Hartford, Connecticut. Woo! Unfortunately. But I gotta say I'm from Hartford everywhere I go, you know? I gotta rep for my city, you know? But I ain't gonna lie, man, Hartford's a piece of shit. But it's my piece of shit, you know? That's kinda like when you shit and you look at it before you flush it. That's how I feel about Hartford, right? You look at it after you shit, before you flush it. Or make sure it's not green, right? You ain't no corn. Just like that piece of shit, it'll always be a part of me. That's how I feel about Hartford, right? I grew up in the North End, man, and if y'all familiar with the news, the North End's a very rough place, man. A lot of crime, a lot of killing, man. I wish that shit can stop. But like growing up, I was never one to commit a crime. That's just not me, you know? Like, I'm too much of a firm believer in karma. And I don't think I can get away with a crime. Cause I got like a really big head, I think I'll be too noticeable. I can't be like, yo, give me your money. Walk off, they be like, yo, Cliff, that's you? And me, I don't like the lies, I be like, yeah, that's me. Man, give me back my motherfucking money. Okay, here you go. Man, head so big, you should use it as a battering ram for like police and shit. Where do you think they're hiding me? I can't rob people. Y'all get it, your friend. Another thing about myself, I'm from the hood, as I already said. I've been chilling white for the past 8 to 9 years. They're from the suburbs and shit, you know, it's cool. I like chilling with people from like different walks of life. You know, I feel like everybody should do that. But one thing I hate is like, I always come across like one white guy. He's always saying like, no offense to me. Like, some things are just not offensive. Like, I get it, our people didn't get along. Like, I read history and all that good stuff. But like, you know, they'd be like,
oh my God, Cliff, I was waiting in Whole Foods. Yum, 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 I just can't get enough.
That's my white guy voice, right? You're not a black comedian unless you got a white guy voice, right?
So I'm waiting in line. I'm just picking up the Whole Foods. And this guy, he farted. It was smelly, really smelly. No offense, he was black.
Like, how is that offensive? Only black people for it? Like, I don't get it. Like, what, white people got it so good? Like, they don't gotta worry about oppression. And all their farts smell like hummus? I've been partying with them too, you know, it's cool. I like partying with them more with like black people. I ain't gonna lie, most of my black friends. I can say these things because I'm black, right? Yeah, me, right? Well, like, you know, sometimes when you party with black people, especially at a club, it gets too hostile. They're like, yo, what you looking at, nigga? I don't know what you looking at, nigga. I don't know, it's a camera right here. I might as well shoot you in front of all these people. Boo, 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 boo. Then the next day, everybody's on Facebook like, oh, man, free Kev, man. He ain't mean to do it. He innocent. He's innocent. Why? He shot somebody on camera like 6 times. And he jaywalked after that? Man, put him in fucking jail, man. I got a criminal. I don't like going to bars because like the music's too loud. You can never hear like you can never go up to a girl and like try and talk to her because the music's too loud. You'd be like, you're pretty, what's your name? Is she living in Maine? No, you're pretty, what's your name? EA Sports in the game? I like going to like frat parties. I used to like going to like house parties back in the days, you know, like frat parties at a frat house. I like it, but like every time I went to like a frat house, there was always that like black white guy. You know, the black white guy, like he grew up in the suburbs, you know, like black on the outside, white on the inside. Like in the inside, he's white, and then like trying to find construction paper in a snowstorm. Took y'all a while to think about that. But he always feel the need to talk to me. Like, I get it. We're the only two black guys at a party. You don't got apology, right?
Hey, what's going on? We're the only two bros at this party, am I right? Am I right? Uh-huh. I mean brothers, I mean like black, right? Because we're not related, we're brothers, am I right? Alright? I was gonna be the only guy here, am I right? Three more black guys, you can beat all these white boys in 5-on-5 basketball, alright? Huh? Stereotypes are black, you get it, right? All these white crackers in here, huh? I guess it's probably needed a little bit of black pepper, you get it? Because they're black. I'm gonna get up this year. You stay right this year. Right. Black lives matter, am I right?
But like, you know, being at fucking parties and like, you know, being drunk and whatnot, as I am a little bit right now. Alright, you too. I drink for that. But you hear a lot of dumb shit from like drunk people. Like one time, you know, me and my friend, he's like 6'6", right? He's mad tall. We're outside, smoking cigarettes, we're talking. Some random drunk guy came up to him and was like, yo, man, you're tall, man. You're like 6'6". Yo, I bet you could jerk off standing up. That's stupid, right? But like, I was a little drunk, so like, you ever hear something and it's like, it sounds stupid, but you gotta make sure it's not really stupid. So I'm like, wait, it's like, I'm 5'10". I'm gonna jerk off sitting down. I can jerk off standing up too, all right. Hey, he didn't say something stupid. Oh man, I'm having a good time. I even like, you know, had a couple sexual encounters with like white women in my life. You know, a couple of them. I remember all 37 of them. No, I don't like lying to people. I remember this one time in particular, right? I'm like fucking this girl on a bag of garbage in a closet at a party. And I know what y'all thinking, you know? The bag was recyclable garbage. I got class, all right? So, you know, I had a condom. It was in my pocket the whole time. But I still had a condom, safe enough, right? The plastic bag and all the recyclable shit, that's like environmental, friendly, whatever, right? So, you know, I'm on top of this girl, and she was said something so stupid to me. I don't know, it just sounded dumb. She was like, oh my God, give me that clip, dang. And like, I wanted to say something, but I was on top of her, and I don't want to squirt my happy juice in her. Happy juice, right? I love that sound. I love the word, happy juice. But I'm thinking in my head, like, who else dick I'm going to give you? Like, what, can you six dicks like the sneakers or something? Like, yo, dog, yo, Pat, let me borrow your dick right fast. Oh, bro, that's the second time you asked me this week. Actually, it's the third time, yo, third time's a charm. Let me borrow your dick right fast, yo. Yours got more girth, man. Ladies like that girth, man. Come on, come on, come on. Okay, here you go, man. Fuck. Bring it back next time. Make sure you clean it. You ain't clean it the last time. Oh, like, what am I, like, Oprah? I'm just giving out cliff dicks. You get a cliff dick. You get a cliff dick. You get a cliff dick. Everybody gets cliff dicks. Woo, it had me. Woo. I'm waiting for it, man. Yeah. I want to talk about more personal shit, as if like, you know, fucking a girl in a bag of garbage ain't like personal enough. I'll be more personal. I never had a girlfriend. I never been in love. I don't know how that shit feels, you know. All right, I don't know, man. But the most romantic thing a woman ever told me was like, let's do this quick before my man gets home. Hey man, I don't know how to feel about that shit, man. Like, I remember one time in particular, I'm like 12 years old, right? Summer 03. And like two of my friends, they had girlfriends, right? They like learning how to make out for the first time and shit, you know, and I was a third wheel. I've always been a third wheel. I'm such a third wheel. Keep burping. I'm such a third wheel. I know how to draw a tricycle out of my cum and my tears. Took out me on that one too. So, you know, they're like, you know, making out with their girlfriends and shit. And, you know, I'm just watching because we all got our things, right? And, you know, my friend's girlfriend tried to hook me with her sister, right? Out of pity, you know, tried to put me on that pity punini. So anyway, she tried to put me on her sister or whatever, right? And her sister dissed me, man. She was just trying to go out with me. She was like, ew, I'm not fucking with Clef, man. That big ass gap he got between his teeth. It looks like somebody pressed a spacebar button twice. That shit hurt me, man. I ain't gonna lie. I tried to like, yeah, me, spacebar, right? I went home, I was sad that day, you know? And when I'm sad, I like to draw my artwork. I can't get these hater boys to fit on to match on this on tricycle. I'm finished. Let me dot the I and my name on my team. I've been doing comedy for a little minute, like 2 years. A little minute. Doesn't make sense, right? I've been doing it for like 2 years. I love it, you know. I hate the stupid shit I hear, you know. Like one time I was at this party and this white girl was like, oh my god, Clef, you did some stand-up last night? I said, yeah, I did some stand-up last night. She's like, how come you ain't tell me? I never would have went, but you still should have told me. I never would have went, but you still should have told me. That doesn't make any fucking sense. That's stupid. That's like saying like, yo man, I got free strawberries right here. Word, they free? Yeah, you gotta pay me $5 though. They free after you buy them. And like, you know, I live in the hood, and like, you know, they see people that I grew up in the hood, they see that I'm, you know, doing my stand-up shit on Facebook. And so like, it's kind of weird walking outside, cause like I might walk, you know, outside to the corner store or whatever, to get a Dutch or whatever. And like, you know, I see the bum ass niggas on the corner not doing nothing. And you know, I walk by them, they're like, yo, what up, Clef? I'm like, yo, what up, bum ass niggas on the corner? You can't walk by people and not say hi, right? That's kind of rude. I'm like, yo, man, I see you be doing your stand-up shit. What? Oh, you think you be doing better than us? Hell no, I don't think I'm doing better than y'all. We living in the hood together, man. You live in 3A, I live in 3B. Like, our roaches are cousins, like. I think I'm doing better than anybody.
Oh, so yeah, so I see you be doing your stand-up shit. Oh, I'm funny too, you feel me? I'm stand-up funny.
I just might get on stage and they might not laugh. What? I mean, you're not funny. That's like saying like, yeah, I'll be fucking my girl real good. She never come, but I still fuck her good, right? She's mad friendly with the UPS man, but I still be fucking her good, right? I'll let him in the left. Shout out to Joe Reddington, man. He's cool. I'm fucking drink. Don't buy myself too. I love this comedy shit though. I love making people laugh. It gives me like a warm feeling. It's kind of like when you hug a big girl. You ever hug a big girl? Don't big girls get the best hugs? Nah, I'm not making fun of big girls. They just get nice hugs, man, you know? You know, beauty comes in all shapes and sizes. I don't discriminate, you know? Well, like warmth, it's only in a big girl, you know? You know, I love them. They're like beanbag chairs with legs. That's my time, everybody.